Situated at the southern tip of the Baja Peninsula south of California, Los Cabos encompasses two communities, the resort town of Cabo San Lucas and the colonial town of San Jose del Cabo. In 1930, the Jesuits built a mission here, which eventually grew into the town of San Jose del Cabo. The town grew slowly at first, with an additional rural village popping up 20 miles down a dirt road in nearby Cabo San Lucas. There were no roads connecting Los Cabos to the rest of the peninsula, and the locals made their living fishing. All that began to change in the 1970s, when the Mexican government targeted the area for development. Today, Cabo San Lucas and San Jose del Cabo host over 60,000 residents, and the road between them, known as the Corridor, is lined with world-class resorts.
We're staying on the Corridor at Dreams Los Cabos Suites Golf Resort and Spa. Its location between the two towns allows us to take advantage of amenities in both locales and easy access to the airport. We booked our trip through Apple Vacations, so we're greeted by one of their representatives who helps us with our luggage, making for an easy transition to town. We make it to the hotel just in time for sunset. So after checking in and checking out all the exciting activities here, we head down to the beach to play in that sand and surf that Cabo is so famous for. The sunset is amazing, with a pale yellow sky playing backdrop to some local caballeros. That's cowboys for all you folk that don't speak Spanish.
So, Los Cabos is known for two things. Its funky desert surroundings, think tall, spiky cactus and lumpy rock formations, and the abundance of sea life. Today, we're going to explore the deserts from the ground and from the air before heading out onto the water to look for Cabo's most famous winter visitors, no, not retirees from up north, whales.
Located about midway between Cabo San Lucas and San Jose del Cabo, just off the corridor, Wild Canyon Adventures offers high-flying fun exploring the desert. Guests are treated to adrenaline-pumping excitement on zip lines and four-wheel drive tours. So we gear up.
They'll never be on its side. They'll always be on its head or on its wheels. This is incredible. And this will not bend and it will not break.
Perfect. Now you hold on to these straps, okay? So all you gotta do is hold on to those straps there, okay?
And then I can put that on the top.
I'm a doctor.
Yeah, hopefully we won't need one of those today. And head out.
We're heading out in these Tom cars on a four-wheel drive adventure with Jamie at Green Zebra Adventures. Let's check out the desert.
Jamie says the Tom cars were originally designed for Israeli combat missions, so the steep canyons and sandy washes here are nothing they can't handle. In fact, this area is known for its exciting terrain, and the people around here take their four-wheeling seriously. So seriously, they've made a profession out of it.
We're at the tip of the Baja Peninsula, the ending point for the famous race, the Baja 1000. It's a race across the deserted landscapes of the Baja Peninsula, through deserts and canyons, off-road race. It's really cool, and it ends right here in Cabo San Lucas. Kind of get a feel for what those racers in the Baja 1000 might go through.
How was that?
That was awesome.
Now imagine doing that for a couple days, all the way from the border of the United States to here. What do you think about that?
Maybe later.